over top. Tasha gets it back in the middle, misses Wah with it, but he recovers on the hash mark. Takes a shot, score! Vermette was there in front, may have gotten a touch. It went right through Dukeman.
Watch the head of the goaltender, Devin Dubnyk. He does not battle to look around Antoine Vermette at all. Look at him. He doesn't see it. He never sees the shot. It's a seeing eye shot that goes between the arm and the body of Devin Dubnyk. But boy, goaltenders have got to be a little bit more active, especially when the puck's down low like that, to look around the screen in front. By the time he gets a peek at it, it's too late. Never a bad idea to put the puck up.
Murphy with him at the Ducks line. Granlund looking, creates some space. Zucker in, scores!
These little east-west plays that the Wild are making, in particular Zucker, but in this case it was Granlund, it just buys time so that you can get the flow of your line coming with you. And Jason Zucker, who we figured would be figuring into some kind of scoring, just given the fact that he's always on the puck, he finds himself a nice little area there that Granlund can just toss the puck to. You see Granlund just pick up his head, and all he sees is Zucker flying in there without anybody checking him.
Or converged there, Winnick out to the line, Prosser a shot, that goes off the skate of Foligno, they score! Mitchell on the rebound, and Minnesota has their first lead of the night.
I think Anaheim got caught puck watching on a very good forecheck by the Wild when that shot came in. A couple of players were banging around in front of the net. One of them was Foligno, one of them was Mitchell, and the Wild were able to take advantage on this good forecheck. And look at the quick play here by Prosser. He didn't wait. He didn't allow the Anaheim Ducks to line up in his shooting lane. And he fires it very quickly on goal. And it's the rebound that the Wild are able to capitalize on with some good net front presence. And a little tonight.
Dumba works in. He scores! Second consecutive overtime game, where Dumba wins it for the Wild.
When you have some ice in overtime, you better take it. And Dumba, with the puck on his stick, realized that nobody was trying to shut him down, and he had plenty of room in front of the goaltender. He was able to walk, and he walked all the way to the far side and jammed it in. A lot of great chances here in overtime. This one, they may have deflected off a stick, but Dumba regroups, and he gets a good feed here at Charlie Coyle, and he walks right to the front of the net, uncontested. That's the second game in a row, as you mentioned, that he scored. Second game in a row that it'll come off the stick of Charlie Coyle. Last game, it was a bit of a fanned shot. This one was a direct pass, and Matt Dumba drives and scores, and the Wild take the win in overtime.
Extends Coyle's scoring streak to six games with the helper on the winner for Dumba. And Minnesota has now won their last three games that have gone into the extra session. One in a shootout and two on OT. GWGs for